أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اتبع هداه إلى يوم نلقاه وبعد. We thank Allah, we praise Him, we beseech His mercies and blessings on His noble Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, His household, His companions and those who tread His path to the day of reckoning. Ameen. Yesterday we were able to explain who Waraqa ibn Nawfal, who he was, and the reason why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to run away whenever he went out, and a caller, an angel called him. So we said Waraqa was not he was alive before the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, though he was a believer. Because he was the follower, some of the scholars, they said he was the follower of Isa alayhi salam. Some said he was the follower of Musa alayhi salam. Though what is clear is that he was a believer. Some said he was even a Sahabi. Some said he wasn't a Sahabi. But what is clear about Waraqa ibn Nawfal is he was a believer. He died as muwahid, mu'minun billah. So, and we said the reason why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to run away, that the way the malak, the angel, used to shake him in the cave, that he couldn't bear it. Whenever he left the cave, he would go home and he would tell the wife, Zamiluni, Zamiluni, cover me, cover me. This is the reason for the fright of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Inshallah, within the very few minutes that we have, we'll quickly look into another aspect of this Surah Al-Fatiha. And that is عدد آيات الفاتحة وهل البسملة آية منها أم لا. The number of verses in Surah Al-Fatiha, how many are they? Is البسملة part of Surah Al-Fatiha or not? Now, there is إجماع, there is consensus regarding the number of verses. Though any other statement that come from other scholars, they are shuzuz, they are scarce, very rare. In fact, some scholars said they may not be correct. Because as regards to the number of verses in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hijr, verse 87, that وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِ وَالْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ. Indeed, we have given you سَبْعًا, seven, مِنَ الْمَثَانِ. And this مَثَانِ, you know, there are different meanings. What is often repeated, or what we use in glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, the sabr there means the number of verses contained in Surah Al-Fatiha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explicitly stated that He gave the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam seven verses. So, here it is clear that the number of verses in Surah Al-Fatiha, there are how many? Seven. لا خلاف في هذا. Any خلاف that you may see is either it is correct or it is rare. والله أعلم. نعم, that is that. البسملة آية منها. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Is he an ayah in Surah Al-Fatiha or not? في هذا خلاف بين أهل العلم. أهل العلم. There is difference of opinions on these. Some said البسملة. The statement بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. آية مستقلة is an independent ayah. وهي من سورة الفاتحة and is part of سورة الفاتحة. Some said no. البسملة ليست من سورة الفاتحة. Is not part of سورة الفاتحة. That is just on its own. Okay. نعم. Let's look at what those who said البسملة آية من الفاتحة. Those who said بسملة is a verse from amongst the verses of Surah Al-Fatiha. Let's see their evidence. And let's, you know, compare and contrast with the evidence of those who say something contrary. For those who said Basmala is part of Surah Al-Fatiha, they use hadith of Ad-Darqutni and Al-Bayhaqi, rahmatullahi alayhima. And the hadith says, إِذَا قَرَأْتُمُ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ. Whenever you are reading Alhamdulillah, فَقُرَأُوا بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ. Read Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Innaha Ummul Kitab was Sabu al Masani. Because بسم الله الحمد لله is the mother of the Quran and is the seven verses that are often repeated. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إحدى آياتها. Because بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم is one of its verses. This hadith صحيح. قال الألباني الإمام الألباني رحمة الله عليه في صحيح الجامع says this hadith is صحيح. But الإمام ابن حجر رحمة الله عليه said the hadith is موقوف. الحديث الموقوف is hadith that does not reach the prophet. It stopped at the Sahaba level. Like, it is a discussion amongst the Sahaba, not that it came from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فهذا والحديث الموقوف. But the opposite one is the one that came from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it is called حديث مرفوع. So, in this regard, this is the evidence of scholars that usually say Bismillah is part of Fatiha. Because it is stated in this hadith that Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim minha is from Surah Al-Fatiha. Now, the second statement, Al-Basmala laysat ayatan min Surah Al-Fatiha. Innama hiya mustaqilla. It is not part of Surah Al-Fatiha, it's just that it is on its own. Just as all other surah have their respective Bismillah. Who can tell us the surah that does not have Bismillah? Surah Al-Tawbah, except Tawbah. All other surah begins with Surah Al-Fatiha. Now, what is their evidence to say Bismillah is not part of Surah Al-Fatiha? They use the hadith that was reported by Al-Imam Malik in his Muwatta, and the one that was reported by Al-Imam Muslim in his Sahih. And Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, from Abu Hurairah, may Allah be pleased with him, call. He said, سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I had a messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, قال الله تبارك وتعالى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قسمت الصلاة بيني وبين عبدي. I have divided the prayer between me and my servant. نصفين. I divided into how many? Into two. فنصفها لي. Part of the prayer is for me. وَنِصْفُهَا لِعَبْدِي. The other part of the prayer is for my servant. وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلْ. And for my servant, whatever he asks. قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Then the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said in that hadith, اِقْرَهُ. So read, يَقُولُ الْعَبْدِ. The servant is saying, أَلْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. يَقُولُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. When the servant says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, Hamadani Abdi, my servant is praising me. Now, if you look at the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ didn't start with Bismillahi Rahman Rahim. He started with what? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. If Bismillah happens to be one of the verses of Surah Al-Fatiha, it would have begun with Bismillahi Rahman Rahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Another evidence. عدم جهر الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم وخلفائه بها في الصلاة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم often at times, most times, he didn't used to say Bismillah out whenever he wanted to recite Surah Al-Fatiha on Salah. After تكبيرة الإرام, دعاء الاستفتاح, الاستعاذة, he would say Basmala. He would say Bismillah, but silently most of the time. A very rare occasion that the prophet pronounced what's it called? Bismillah aloud. But his sunnah is he would say it silently. If Bismillah is to be part of Surah Al-Fatiha, there is no need of saying that silently and beginning with Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin. Our Sahabi radiyallahu anhu, Anas, he said, صليت خلف النبي. I prayed behind the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وأبي بكر. I prayed behind Abu Bakr. وعمر, I prayed behind Umar. وعثمان, I prayed behind Uthman. All of them. فَكَانُوا يَسْتَفْتِحُونَ. And they used to begin their recitation with Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. لَا يَذْكُرُونَ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ. They didn't used to say بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ فِي أَوَّلِ كِرَاءَ, in the beginning of the recitation. وَلَا فِي آخِرِهَا. Neither did they used to say it at the end. Now, if you remember the hadith of Abu Sa'id al-Mu'alla that we mentioned a couple of days ago, the hadith also mentions Alhamdul Kul Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. He didn't say Kul Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. But This is where we are going to conclude. It is clear that there is difference of opinions as regards to is Bismillah. Even if you look at the Quran, I think the Kufa and the Al Kufi wal Makki, the numbering of the Quran, this halves that we use, you will see that Bismillah is number one. If I'm not mistaken,
yeah,
Bismillah is number one. Okay, so in some other riwayat, Bismillah is not counted as number one. In the halves that we use, you say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim one, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen two, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim three, Malik Yawmiddin four, Iyyaka na'budu wa Iyyaka nasta'in five, Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim six, right? Sirat al-ladina an'amta alayhim ghayr al-maghdubi alayhim wala ad-dallin. In some other riwayat, Bismillah is not part of it. The beginning is Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen 1, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim 2, Maliki Yawmiddin 3, Iyyaka Na'budu wa Iyyaka Nasta'in 4, Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim 5, Sirat al-ladina an'amta alayhim 6, غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. So the breakage in the Quran does not really tell if Bismillah is part of it or not. It's just to give, you know, stop and all that to the Quran. Wallahu alam. But in this regard, I would say the one that is weightier, wallahu alam, is that لا بسملة في سورة الفاتحة. إنما هي آية مستقلة كما كانت في الصور الأخرى. So there is no Bismillah as part of Surah Al-Fatiha is an independent verse, just as other surah also have their own Bismillah. But it is compulsory that you say it whenever you are praying on Salah, but it is silent. Wallah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, we'll stop here and we'll continue from here tomorrow. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك. السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته.